Hello everyone, in this video you have one triangle, and here is given 8 units, and here is given 10 degrees, here is given 50 degrees, here is given 20 degrees, and then this length x is asked. Okay. First of all, we know that two interior angles equals one exterior angle. Right? So this angle must be equal to 30 degrees. And then if you focus on this triangle, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. Therefore, 100 degrees left here. Okay. After that, if you focus on this triangle, notice that ratio of this two angle equal 2. Right? So that means we can calculate an isosceles triangle. Let's remind you, if we have a triangle with base angles ratio of 2, let's call this angle alpha and this angle 2 alpha. If we take an angle of alpha degrees from here, we get an isosceles triangle. Triangle is an isosceles triangle. Or you can think like this. Let's call here x. If we extend this corner by x unit, we will again obtain an isosceles triangle. Right? Therefore, these two angles will be alpha degrees. Next step, if you focus on the biggest triangle is also an isosceles triangle. Therefore, we can use one of the two depending on the situation of the problem. Okay. Let's return the question. If we take an angle of 10 degrees from here, we get an isosceles triangle. So here must be equal 20 degrees. And then let's call here point O. Notice that these two angles are equal. That means this triangle is also an isosceles triangle. So if here is x, that means here must be equal x. We know that this triangle is an isosceles triangle as well. So this length is also x unit. Right? This angle here is 160 degrees, right? And notice that these two lengths are equal, right? And then if you notice that some of the opposite angles equal 200 60 degrees, right? So what does this mean? And what should we understand from here? If you notice that 2 times 100 plus 160 equal 360, right? That means if we draw circumcircle of the quadrilateral, the circle passes through three corners, and the center of the circle is at the other corner. After that, if we connect center with corner A, if you notice that all three sides are also radius, right? Therefore, this length here is also x unit. After that, if you focus on triangle AOC, these two lengths are equal. So if it is 60 degrees, that means here must be equal 60 degrees, right? As a result, here is also 60 degrees. That means triangle AOC is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, x is going to be 8 units. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. We know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees, so angle BAC must be equal 100 degrees. And then if you focus on this triangle, notice that here must be equal 130 degrees, right? So that means this is an obtuse angle. Therefore, if you draw the circumcircle of triangle BDC, the center of the circumcircle will be outside the triangle, right? Let's remind you, let's draw three triangles, 1, 2, and 3. First scenario, if alpha is an acute angle, and second scenario, if alpha is 90 degrees, and the last one, if alpha is an obtuse angle. Okay. In first scenario, if alpha is an acute angle, the center of the circumcircle is located inside the triangle. And the second scenario, if alpha is 90 degrees, the center of the circumcircle is located on the hypotenuse. And also, these are radius, and this length is also radius. The last scenario, if alpha is greater than 90 degrees, that means the center of the circumcircle is located outside of the triangle. So, if we connect center with corners of the triangle, these three lengths are radius. Right? Okay. Let's clear here. So now, if we apply this property for the question, notice that here is an obtuse angle. That means if we draw circumcircle of this triangle, center of the circumcircle is located outside of this triangle. Right? And then, if we connect center with corners of the triangle, like this, these three lengths are radius. And then, notice that if it is 10 degrees, here must be equal 20 degrees. And if it is 20 degrees, that means here must be equal 40 degrees. If you focus on this triangle, these are equal, right? So notice that if here is 60 degrees, these are must be equal 60 degrees, right? That means triangle BOC is an equilateral triangle. So let's color all three sides in red, like this. And this side should also be red, right? After that, if you focus on triangle DOB, this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So if it is 20 degrees, that means here must be equal 80 degrees. So now, if you focus on this triangle, let's call here point T, triangle TBD is also an isosceles triangle, right? So here is also 80 degrees. And then if here is x, that means here must be equal x minute. And then if you focus on this triangle, the angles of this triangle are 60, 20, and 100. Right? So now if you focus on triangle ABC, the angles of this triangle are same angles, right? And also notice that opposite sides of the 100 degrees have same length, right? So that means this triangle and this triangle are congruent, right? So triangle BAC and triangle OTB are congruent, right? Okay. You know that congruent triangles have same side and angles. That means if there's an 8 unit opposite side of the 20 degrees, opposite side of the 20 degrees must be equal 8 units. Okay. Now you will calculate value of x using third methods. You know that here is 100 degrees and angle is 30 degrees. Let's call here y for the triangle. If we apply sine rule, so 8 over sine 30 equal y over sine 100. Therefore, y equal 8 times sine 100 over sine 30, right? You know that sine 30 equal 1 over 2. That means y equal 16 times sine 100. So now, for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, x over sine 10 equal y over sine 20, right? We know that y equal 16 times sine 100 and we know that the expansion of sine 20 equal 2 times sine 10 times cosine 10. So these are again, you know that sine 100 equals sine 80 and cosine 10 is also equal sine 80. Therefore, these are also again. So x equal 8 units. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.